लोगों के बीच में ये कौरव पांडव का झगड़ा कब समाप्त होगा मुझे समझ नहीं आते फोटोग्राफर्स और वीडियोग्राफर्स के बीच में। माई केंद्र सरकार में सूचना प्रसारण मंत्रालय में मेरे साथी कर्नल राजवर्धन सिंह राठौर जी, मेरा सचिव अजय मित्तल जी, देश में अलग अलग प्रदेशों से आए हुए मंत्रीगण, सचिव और निर्देशक और अन्य पदाधिकारीगण और मेरे विभाग का सभी अधिकारी मित्रों, ये बहुत साल का विराम के अंतर विराम के बाद ये कंसल्टेशन या वर्कशॉप और कॉन्फ्रेंस हो रहे। वी आर हैविंग इट ऑलमोस्ट आफ्टर ए गैप ऑफ 8 ईयर्स, स्टेट इंफॉर्मेशन मिनिस्टर्स एंड सेक्रेटरीज कॉन्फ्रेंस। Very important. I came to know of it. I was really surprised why it's not being held regularly. That's why people also seems to have lost some interest also in between because of long gap. But whatever it is, this is very much required because we are a team India. We have to work together, center and state. Without the states progressing, you cannot claim the country has progressed. So you need an integrated, a holistic approach for the development of the country, for implementation of the programs and policies of central government and state government, and there has to be regular interaction, understanding, cooperation and coordination. That is the purpose behind this meeting. Friends, I'm told yesterday secretaries they had a meeting and then they had a meaningful dialogue. This is not meant for speech giving. It's mostly understand what are the initiatives of the government of India and then what are the problems faced by the state, suggestions, etc. That is the purpose of this consultation. Because through consultation, you'll have better understanding of the situation and you find better solutions also. The information dissemination to the people is very vital at the central level, at the state level. Now we are an independent country. So the agenda of the nation is development. Second, development. Third, development. And development also, all-round development, integrated development. That's why the Prime Minister has given a slogan, Sabka Saath, Sabka Vikas. Only few people becoming rich are presiding over big empires is no development. And that, unless the development reaches the last man in the queue, the development has no meaning. That's what our mentors, Pandit Dindal Upadhyaya, our great leader, Dr. Babasaheb Ambedkar, they all told us, Antyodaya, uplifting the poorest of the poor, taking care of the last man in the queue. That should be the priority of any government, whether it is BJP government, some other party government, in state, a regional party government or a national party government. The agenda should be development, integrated development, holistic development, and development reaching the last man in the line and everybody getting a feeling that I am also part of this development story. Main bhi isme bhagidari hu. Jab tak aap ye impression nahi de payenge, vikas ka koi matlab nahi hai. Main kisi ka alochana nahi karna chahta hu, is sandarbh bhi nahi hai, avsar bhi nahi hai, matlab bhi nahi hai. Hum log sab milkar development ko मेन एजेंडा पर लाना चाहिए. उसमें इंफॉर्मेशन एंड ब्रॉडकास्टिंग मिनिस्टर्स का, सेक्रेटरीज का, डायरेक्टर्स का, अधिकारियों का, संस्थाओं का, पीएबी का, स्टेट इंफॉर्मेशन सर्विस लोगों का, सेंटर में जो लोग अन्य अन्य विभागों में काम कर रहे हैं, सबका दायित्व तो बनता है. सो वी हैव टू कीप दैट इन माइंड एंड देन मूव फॉरवर्ड बिकॉज we have to pass on the information to the people who are our masters. They are the masters. We are the servants of the people. Secondly, the interaction between the center and the state, between the state and the local body on regular intervals is also need of the hour. The Prime Minister has accorded more importance for center-state relations, cooperative federalism, and is stressing on Team India. The third one is, as I was saying, ours is a developing country. The central and state governments are equal partners in formulating. They have equal responsibility also. So that is the essence of the cooperative federalism. And the principle of Team India is incomplete without consultation and without involvement. Then now our perspective is, as I told you, we have to evolve an effective developmental communication. Information with confirmation, I say, is the great ammunition. It's an ammunition against injustice. It's an ammunition against corruption. It's an ammunition against inequalities. It's ammunition against harassment. It's ammunition against discrimination on the basis of caste, religion, or region. Or it's an ammunition against injustice or denial to the people, which they are due. They are not getting it. So that information is such powerful, but it has to be confirmation. Information without confirmation, it will not have any effect on the people, because we are seeing headline banta hai, headline. Headline pahle ek din ka hote the headline. Abhi wo headline, 2 minute mein headline, deadline ho jaya, dusra headline aa raha. Karan kya hai, usme koi line hai nahi. Jisme line hai na, line. Mane matlab, mane kuch dam. कुछ तथ्य वो लाइन रेरी हेडलाइन होता है पूरा दिन के लिए भी नहीं तो महीने के लिए भी हेडलाइन होता है दैट इज अ हेडलाइन बिकॉज देयर इज समथिंग नाउ टुडे रिमोनेटाइजेशन इज अ हेडलाइन वेदर यू लाइक इट और नॉट दैट इज अ हेडलाइन देयर आर पीपल हु थिंक दैट डेवलपमेंट इज नो न्यूज आई से एंड पीपल फील डेवलपमेंट इज ओनली न्यूज फॉर देम डेवलपमेंट शुड बी द हेडलाइन And destruction should be the sideline. But unfortunately, what is happening is sideline is becoming headline, and headline is becoming sideline. We have to reverse this. I am not talking about this government or that government. This has been happening over the years. So now we have to correct that. States have a shake. States are doing wonderful things, so many states. They have the development taking place because they are the real executors. We are the formulators. And sometimes we fund, sometimes we frame regulations and then give it to you. You people have to implement them. And ultimately, you know that center has no direct post office in the state. It is the state which runs the show. So keeping that in mind, we must all see to it that we bring back development to the fore and the agenda of life of the people. Because we are not under foreign rule now. We are ruling ourselves. That's one important thing I feel that information ministers of the state, they should all focus in the coming days. This narrative has to be changed. And then what is development? Development is all about activation of country's physical and material resources in order to increase production of goods and services required by the people. That is development. Thereby leading to the general progress and welfare of the people. Raising the living standards of the people, that is development. So anything happening in that direction, people getting house, people getting regular water, people getting power, people getting some remunerative rise for the farmers, women getting their due, the disabled people being provided with some other additional facilities, this is all development. This is all news for them, for those people. What we are all now trying to be influenced by political agendas of the political parties and the leaders, and we try to run the show on that, and then we have discussions in the studios also. But the focus of the discussion should be on the development, should be on raising the living standards of the people, and should be on the improvement of the quality of life for the common man. This is how I feel. Otherwise, we are doing injustice to the people. See, how do you go about the task of development? The government on their own can achieve this development without people's participation? I say no, it's not possible. I am afraid it cannot be. While the people are at large, they are the target of this development, they should be partners in the development. Then only it will gel well or sell well. Since independence, there has been a substantial change in the principles and context of governance, from the primacy of governments in identifying the needs of the people and accordingly formulating developmental plans and programs, the focus now has shifted to participation of the people in socio-economic transformation. Without people's participation, nothing will succeed. No scheme will succeed. We have seen the recent Swachh Bharat, how the people are participating. The Prime Minister told me, I repeat it in every meeting, the Prime Minister told me, don't make it a government program, don't make it a political program. Isko rajneetik rang mat dijiye. Sarkari karyakram mat kariye. Isko janandolan banaiye. He said, make it a people's movement. It is becoming a people's movement now. It is becoming the people's movement now. The process is on and it is getting stimulated. And secondly, even in the smart cities, I have the experience where people in indoor cities, out of 26,50,000 population, 6 lakh people have given their views how they want to have their city in future. Then, if the people's participation is there, your program will be successful and your development story will have full meaning. So, we must always focus on the people. This underlines the need for making people informed participants in the decision-making and development planning process. If you inform them, they will confirm their participation. Without information, giving a lecture alone will not suffice. A developing country like ours needs a strong developmental support communication approaches. Given the socio-economic cultural issues of our country, the public information and communication should increasingly become development-oriented, promoting health, economic and social well-being of the people. In the process, people need to be empowered to understand what is due for them, what they are getting, what they are not getting. It in essence means to look at the people as part of the solution rather than source of problems. Development support communication is a process of information sharing about the development agendas and planned actions. This links planners, beneficiaries and implements of developmental actions. This obligates the planners and implementers to provide clean, explicit and intelligible data and information about their goals and roles in development and explicitly providing opportunities for the beneficiaries. This requires an analysis of the communication environment, of the available and needed communication experiences and resources, including hardware, software, competence and resources, including the financial, human, and clearly indicates expected results from specific resource inputs so as to maintain accountability. Accountability also is much important. Friends, this is a legitimate function of the government, nothing to feel shy. No, government ke bare mein, government maane kya hai? Government is elected by the people. And then what the government is doing? The government is doing for the people. So that there is no need to be shy in highlighting a development story. Doordarshan, for example, or Our India Radio, championing the cause of the digital India, digital transformation, is really a legitimate way of serving the people, educating the people, training the people, motivating the people. There's nothing to feel shy. Others may differ, that's a different matter, for whatever reason it is. We are public broadcasters. And also, I told my secretary, the moment I took stock of the situation, we have an education policy, we have an environmental policy, we have an export and import policy, we have an FDI policy, we have a trade policy, we have an IT policy, we have a science policy, we have a labor policy. But unfortunately, after 69 years, we don't have a communication policy. The center and states, we must work together to evolve a communication policy, broad contours of the communication policy. In absence of such policy, our approaches all these years have been ad hoc with the suboptimal people's presentation and outcomes. So that's why I told my secretary and other officers to apply their mind, interact with you people, and then let us combinedly evolve a communication policy. I would have liked this conference to discuss such a policy. Since the draft is still to be prepared, we need to meet again to discuss it at length once it's finalized, draft is finalized. The broad objectives of such national information and communication policy should be, according to me, I have primary thoughts, to enhance access to information. People have a right, it is a fundamental right to have information. And they have a right to have communication, infrastructures, new technologies, especially in the rural areas. Two, to promote the national dialogue on development issues by all citizens and facilitate informed participation of people in setting development agenda and its execution. Three, to rationalize multi-sectoral investments in information and communication hardware and software through their consolidation and appropriate integration in development plans and planning structure. Fourthly, to ensure the timely, orderly, effective growth of information and communication institutions and professions through standards setting, capacity building, and human resource development. Fifthly, to broadly define the roles of different governments at various levels and other stakeholders. Sixth, to preserve national cultural identity. That is our duty, to preserve. Jo hamara purvajon ne humko diya. वो दिया और हमको दिया विरासत में मिला उसको कायम रखना चाहिए इट इज आवर बाउंडेड ड्यूटी एंड एनहांस द डेवलपमेंटल ऑफ कल्चरल एंड आर्टिस्टिक कैपेबिलिटीज एंड इंस्टीट्यूशंस व्हाइल एनेबलिंग प्रोडक्टिव रीजनल एंड इंटरनेशनल एक्सचेंज वी हैव डिफरेंट रीजियंस डिफरेंट रिलीजियंस डिफरेंट फूड हैबिट्स डिफरेंट लिविंग हैबिट्स बट ब्रॉडली आवर कल्चर आवर हेरिटेज इज वन एंड द सेम So we have to have a mix. Vividhata mein ekata, Bharat ka visheshata. Alag bhasha, alag vesh, phir bhi apna ek desh. This is what our people have been saying. So we have to integrate all these things. You can't thrust something on somebody. And moreover, in India, it's impossible. In spite of Britishers coming, Mughals coming, others coming, a lot of people came, all Tam, Dick and Harry were in the world, they all came here. They might have robbed our wealth, but they have not been able to take away our culture. They had some peripheral influence here and there. And moreover, they all are assimilated. That's why and the Prime Minister have championed the cause of yoga. 192 countries have readily accepted. That's a great art. Time-tested art. Yoga is a time-tested art. Spirituality also, worldwide, world is looking towards India. India is the spiritual capital of the world. That's the trend. So keeping that in mind, we here, we have to see that our culture and our heritage is preserved, common culture. I'm not talking of religion. Religion is a way of worship. Culture is a way of living. Culture is a way of living. Religion is a way of worship. Sometime back when I was giving a lecture, someone asked me, sir, what is culture? I said, culture is a way of living. So what is a way of living? Then how are we different? I tried to explain him. He was saying, no, say it in this thing, sir. Then I said, culture means, Indian culture, Bharatiya culture means, if you have a bread, roti. If you eat your roti, that is prakriti. If you snatch away the other fellow's roti and eat it, that is vikriti. And if you share your roti with the neighbor, then it is samskriti. That is the culture of India. That's what I told him also. Because so that then he understood. That's how we are different from others. To support national and local development initiatives and improve the quality of life of the people by facilitating systemic and effective use and coordination of communication and information strategies and outcomes. National and local development initiatives. There are very beautiful initiatives taken by certain states, certain local bodies. We should really converse them and then showcase to others also. Because India is a nation of wise men. Wise men learn from others' experience and fools learn from their own experience. We are all wise men. So we learn from others' experience. Then I would like to request all the ministers and senior officials from state to further reflect on the need and dimensions of a national information and communication policy. What I said is not the finality. Those are my initial thoughts. I took over the ministry recently only. I just shared my ideas with secretary and others. And I am also opening up and then requesting you all, please open up, discuss at your state level, come with concrete sessions and let the draft be prepared and then we put the draft for discussion across the country and then we will evolve a policy. Friends, the governments here are ruled by different parties, but everybody's effort is development, raising the standards of the living of the people in their own way. Now we have to come out of this Bimaru mindset. Now slowly states, now nobody can call Chhattisgarh, Jharkhand, Madhya Pradesh, or Rajasthan are Bimaru states now. Even UP is catching up, Bihar is catching up. So we have to focus on those states, and they are also advancing. That's a happy thing now. Ultimate interest of the country is to see that there is no Bimaru anywhere. The Prime Minister Narendra Modi has suggested a simple formula: reform, transform, and perform. Reform, perform, and transform. To position our country in a sustainable high growth rate, states need to really rise to the occasion, because of the rising aspirations of the young India can be met only under the conditions of rapid economic growth. The economic disparities is a matter of concern. Yesterday I was reading a magazine, the disparities of economic this thing is 81% India. And you know, a lot of property is held, wealth is held by only few people. So we need to decentralize it. We need to see that it is distributed to all people. And of course, everybody according to their merit, according to their work, according to their contribution and all. But artificial wealth generation is now threatening the countries. Economic inequalities are no good for the country. That's why the Prime Minister has come out with this new idea of a fight against black money and then corruption. And we should all join together in this fight, leaving aside our political considerations. So we may have our approaches differently. I do agree, there's nothing wrong. One can have some other thoughts, but there cannot be two opinions in fighting corruption. There cannot be two opinions in fighting black money, ending the menace of counterfeit, ending the menace of terrorism, ending the menace of drug trafficking, ending the menace of women trafficking, ending the menace of arms trafficking, smuggling and all. There cannot be two opinions on this. So we should all join together and work in that direction. Political debate and discourse, of course, that will be going on. But at the same time, we should not politicalize all issues which are in the larger interest of the country. So friends, this agenda for this conference has been circulated to all of you in advance. Senior officials from both the center and state, you had a marathon discussion yesterday. I'm sure the ministers who are present here, seven of them, they will also throw their ideas. And then this will give a fillip to the media, entertainment and communication sector, which is a valuable segment of our national economy. This is sought to be achieved through enhancing ease of doing business to promote India as a filming destination, pushing digitization of TV sets, effective use of social media, taking full advantage of All India Radio, Doordarshan and Publication Division. The really AAR and DD are pride of our nation. We should encourage them because they are public broadcasters. They are not started for commercial purpose. They are public broadcasters. Now after this Prasara Bharati has come, I am told some states are taking a view. So it's not a government, it's an independent thing. So we should apply commercial rates to them. See, idea of converting Doordarshan and India Radio into Prasara, bringing them under Prasara Bharati, idea is not to have political interference, that's all. But at the same time, they are doing the duty of a public broadcaster. So I request upon all the states, ministers and secretaries, please give a preferential treatment to Doordarshan and R&D Radio. Use them also as your institutions to reach the people as far as the development agenda is concerned. With regard to land allocation, sometimes people say, no, commercial rates and all. How can you give a land and a commercial rate to a R&D Radio station or Doordarshan? Secondly, sensitizing your DMs about their responsibilities with regard to content regulation. Recently we heard in certain places, Peace TV was telecasting without any hindrance because the DMs are overburdened. They have so many things on their head. So there has to be a mechanism, and there has to be a designated officer at the district level. This is my appeal to all states. I am going to write to the chief ministers again. Please authorize and designate an officer who will take care of the violations of the cable TV operators. or MSOs, whatever you call. And also, we should really and see to it that DD is mandatory, but some people are not showing DD, cable operators. And then action as per the law is to be taken by the district magistrate. DCs are under state government. We can communicate with them, but let us say they are overburdened. That's why I said let there be a designated officer for this purpose within the district administration who will be prompt in taking action against violations. We have to work together and we have to strengthen the development of the process of the country. We must build a strong and stable nation, as I was telling. So please, with regard to power supply, with regard to water supply, with regard to land supply, with regard to mind supply, all these things, without application of mind. What mind supply means? Collector has to be applying his mind, na? He's busy with so many things. The collectors in nowadays are like prime ministers of the country in the district. They have more power, so many things, British regime. I have no complaint. I have no complaint also. But same thing is that, you know, on how many things they apply their mind. But that's why I'm saying that there be a designated officer in consultation with the collector, DM or joint DM or XYZ. So this agenda also includes effective implementation of the cable TV network rules to ensure that no effort is made to disrupt social harmony and law and order. Some people argue, sir, it's free country, sir, free. We are free. What is free? Are you free? You are paid, na? You are saying free, na? Then you are saying free, then make it free also. They won't. Secondly, in democracy, dissent is agreeable, but disintegration is not acceptable. And if you say, I am a free country, I'll go and talk freely, I'll abuse other communities, there'll be rights. There'll be social tension. So you have a social responsibility. And if you are a free country, I go out of Vijnan Bhavan, I'm a free man, I will drive this side, and then they will drive this side, and then both of you will meet there on the road, and then finally meet there. Choice is yours, either heaven or hell, whatever it is. So free means there will be some regulation. That's why even the one-way traffic regulation and all, they're part of democracy. Democracy always will have some regulation. Democracy will be successful provided if there are regulations. Otherwise, it will not. Democracy do not mean mobocracy. If you talk on those lines, it will become a hypocrisy. It is not realistic. One has to be clear. The idea is to felicitate each other and to take care of others' concern also, and then bring a social order. So that's the duty. See, friends, as I told you, we are all equal partners in this process. We have so many initiatives like Swachh Bharat Mission, Smart City Mission, Affordable Housing Mission, Atal Mission for Regeneration, Urban Transformation, Beti Bachao, Beti Padao, Crop Insurance, Social Security Scheme from the centre. States also have so many flagship programs. Many of them are doing a good job, great job. And implementation is important. The other day I was in Chennai for the funeral of late Chief Minister Madam Jayalalithaji. The amount of affection people have shown, what does it indicate? The amount of help people got from the leader, that was again shown. I was standing there from morning 6:30 to evening 4 o'clock. Massive. So the welfare and development, again, development includes welfare. There is a misconception again. I would like to clarify on that. Welfare and development, they are not contradictory. They are complementary. If you say, I am developing the country, wait for another 10 years. Till such time, fellows will die. So you have to take care of those helpless people. You have to give them support also. But at the same time, ultimate development means increasing production, creating wealth, and then distributing the wealth. If you don't create wealth and distribute wealth, you will become pauper. So you have to create wealth, first of all, before distributing wealth. Creating wealth and distributing wealth can go hand in hand, simultaneously. That is very much required. That has to be kept in mind. See, the center and state, as I was telling, we must forge a partnership. Some of these information ministers are, I am told, are the chief ministers themselves in many of the states. That's an advantage, of course, but at the same time, little disadvantage is consultation process, and all chief ministers also have so many other obligations and other works on hand. So, in the end, let me quote George Bernard Shaw on the communication. He said the biggest problem in communication is the illusion that it has taken place. This applies more to the communication campaigns of governments. Many people in the government, we cannot take communication for granted until we reach the last citizen and the beneficiary with the necessary information that could make a difference to his life. Unless it makes a difference to his life, he will not believe the communication. Seeing is believing. So let us keep this in mind. There will be some definite positive outcomes that will be emerging out of this. My colleague, Sri Rajavardhan, who is young and dynamic, he is taking notes of all the suggestions you have made yesterday, and I will also be there to take note of the suggestions that are going to be made by my senior my ministers from states. I would like to make a simple announcement. Most Film Friendly State Award at present carries a medal, Rajat Kamal, and a certificate only. Rajat Kamal and a certificate medal. However, it is felt that to encourage the ease of film shooting in various states and thereby promote Indian cinema by encouraging healthy competition among the states, a cash component of rupees 1 crore for the most film-friendly state will be given every year hereafterwards. This is an announcement I want to make on the occasion of this. I hope the states will take advantage of the same and become film-friendly. Ease of approvals, easy permissions for location shootings, then other incentives like tax incentives, etc., they can be thought of. Because entertainment is part of the life. You cannot live without entertainment. And we politicians cannot live without entertaining people. Keeping that in mind, the government gives importance to entertainment also. So we have to encourage such entertainment, which has become part of our life. This is not nothing new. It has been part of our tradition from age-old days. And I have just seen outside how the entertainment cinema can be a very great communicator. The Ajadi Sattar Saal Yaad Karo Qurbani, we had a function. Now our films division and NFDC, they have come out with an exhibition outside about the films, patriotic films. Many of them. I would request all of you, please, during the recess, go around, see all those things. Great films. In Kannada, in Telugu, in Malayala, in Tamil, in Hindi, in Marathi, in Punjabi, in Assami, different languages. Great! Films means we have an opinion. Films means dance and song and music and then dancing, etc. alone. No. Films also can inspire people. There are social messages. There are patriotic messages. Some of them are great actors, great directors, great creative people we have. So there is an exhibition here, really. And we have RQs also. In fact, the states must take advantage of the RQs, National RQs Mission. What is there with the center? That should also be made available to the states also. This is my view, and I have already told my ministry officials. Friends, I am very happy to be admitting you today for this today's function. We are running against the time everywhere. Yesterday night, yesterday morning, I was in Bangalore for a national communicators workshop, communication workshop, Bangalore. In the evening I came to Hyderabad for the function. Came here by morning, 12:05 in the morning. And again evening I have to fly and then go to some other this thing. Because as I told you, aspirations are high, demands are increasing. We should all really run, not run away, run for the cause. I hope all of you will understand this message and then cooperate in the efforts of the central government in making this country stable and strong and prosperous. Thank you very much. Namaskar. This I inaugurate this conference.